This video will teach you how to improve your shoulder stability. This means stronger and less painful shoulders. The scapula pushup is an exercise which will strengthen your serratus anterior. This muscle starts on your lower ribs and inserts into the shoulder blade. The movement the serratus anterior can do includes protraction, upward rotation, external rotation, and it's responsible for keeping the scapula flush with the thorax. If you're someone who has issues with winging, serratus strength is a good place to start. By building a strong base to work from, a stable scapula position, the mobile shoulder joint will have increased force production without even increasing strength. This basically means if your shoulder blades have the ability to be in a good position during exercise, the arms will inherently be stronger. This is because your shoulder muscles will be in a better length to produce force. Also, many injuries can be attributed to poor scapular mechanics. Strengthening your serratus is one way to promote healthier shoulders, especially with overhead exercises. Let's talk about what makes up correct form for the scap pushup. I want you to place your hands underneath your shoulders or slightly forwards towards your head. Before you start, engage your stomach muscles to prevent arching the lower back. Make sure the elbows are straight, and it is extremely important that they stay straight during the entire exercise. From here, I want you to lower slowly and with control into full retraction by squeezing the shoulder blades together. Now protract the shoulders, allowing the scapula to separate maximally. Keep in mind the range of motion is quite small. The important thing is to focus on the quality of the movement, speed, and avoiding compensations. After a few reps, you should feel a vague ache around the rib cage. This means you're doing it right. Now let's take a look at the common mistakes people make time and time again with the scap pushup. These are the form faults your body will naturally want to adopt, so be strict on yourself and avoid doing them. As the scap pushup uses a small range of motion, I see that people generally compensate by flexing their upper back when they should be really protracting. All we want to do is retract and protract the scapula instead. Lowering into retraction is a lot harder than it looks, especially if the body is not used to the movement. Bending the elbows is a compensatory movement instead of retracting. As always, it's best to move slow to avoid this from happening. With any bracing position, such as when you're in a push-up, relaxing the lower back is simply sloppy technique. Stay rigid throughout the entire body and just move the scaps. How many people have you seen rush their scap push-ups? Do you really think you're able to teach full range of motion control by moving so quickly? Surprise, surprise, no you can't. Slow down and do it properly. Only if you can do the kneeling scap push-up with perfect form and no cheating do I want you to move on to the following progressions. I'll show you them in order of difficulty so you can keep progressing over time. In a push-up position, the load will be increased through the shoulder complex. Keep in mind the form recommendations above. It's best to do it slow, controlled, with quality reps to teach and reinforce good movement patterns and proper body mechanics. You can increase the load of the movement by using a resistance band. I'm using the bands by Rubber Bandits. You can get a link to buy these in the description. Very high quality, highly recommend them, guys. I like using bands as the resistance will peak at the top of the protraction portion. Equally as important is the band forces you to control eccentric protraction as you lower into retraction. This is my favorite method for increasing load in the two-arm scap push-up. If you feel like one shoulder is weaker than the other, unilateral work with the single-arm scap push-up is absolutely ideal. This movement is quite challenging as now you've got to control one shoulder with a decent amount of bodyweight loading. It's also harder to maintain your lumbo-pelvic control because now you've got to resist rotational forces acting on the body. As before, keep the entire body rigid and avoid rotating or twisting the trunk during the single arm scap push-up. An alternate method for loading the scap push-up without using bands is simply to add weight. When using this progression, you'll have to elevate your hands and feet to comfortably work through a full range of motion, and remember to only increase load if your form remains on point. Let's take this exercise to the next level of fun. An unstable surface will increase the stability demands of your posterior shoulder muscles and further challenge the serratus anterior. Who wants to challenge me to a pickup game? 1v1 me, bro. What? Now, the scap push-up is a good exercise, but it's not perfect. As we know, the pec minor is a synergist during the scapular push-up. If your pec minor is overactive, it'll actually be harder for your serratus anterior to do its thing. I recommend the following changes to technique so that you can preferentially use your serratus anterior over your pec minor. I like to focus on externally rotating the shoulders by rotating the elbow pits forward. The other thing to make sure your serratus is doing the work is hand placement, so at least place your hands underneath your shoulders, or if you really want to work the serratus anterior, place the hands further away from the head. This creates a greater upward rotation in this position. This combined with the external rotation of the shoulder will just make sure that your serratus is more likely to work than your pec minor. The last cue that I find helpful, and just to feel the serratus working more, is to drive the hands away from the body. This just increases the serratus activation and it combines with that external rotation and upward rotation that we've been applying before. In terms of the scap push-up, when you should do it, how many you should do, I like to do one set prior to my upper body training, just as a warm-up and an activation, just to get things primed for your session. If serratus strength is a real issue for you, I recommend a few times per week applying progressive overload to the exercise using multiple sets and a standard rep range of 8 to 15. Thanks for watching. Leave your thumbs up and comments below. Subscribe to Fitness FAQ's YouTube page if you haven't already, and visit fitnessfaqs.tv to learn more and master your body.